4 Green Bay Metro firefighters' names were added to the International Memorial of Fallen Firefighters this year. Sunday was the first time they were recognized locally for dying in the line of duty from cancer. NBC 26's Abigail Hankey takes us to the ceremony.
Their names were called
Milton Newman,
and the bell rang, signaling the final alarm for these 4 fallen firefighters who died in the line of duty.
Time does not diminish the significance of the loss. And particularly with these 4 being cancer, this is a lesson learned.
The men's names were added to the Wisconsin Memorial of Fallen Firefighters last year, but were most recently added to the International Memorial in Colorado Springs.
I pray we would have the heart, all of us, of a first responder.
While many families could not make it to that ceremony, Sunday, those flags were handed to family members in Green Bay.
The first member recognized died in 1959, the following 2 in 1972, and the 4th member honored died in 1973. Now, while the Green Bay Metro Fire Chief says they didn't know these men personally, he thanked them for helping save firefighters' lives today.
We owe a debt of gratitude to your loved ones.
The department says through research of 40,000 career firefighters, a direct link was found between the profession and cancer, meaning firefighters have a 202% increased risk of developing cancer from smoke inhalation.
The smoke from plastics is so dangerous. It's full of toxins. We didn't recognize that. So we didn't clean our gear. And that smell was a mark of courage, a mark of an accomplishment.
The Green Bay Metro Fire Department now has 15 protocols in place to help against cancer.
Every firefighter is required to have an annual physical now, and in that we include a full check for melanoma, which is skin cancer. It's one of the most prominent cancers that firefighters can get.
While a lot of time has passed since these men's deaths, their memories and service are now written in stone. In Green Bay, Abigail Hankey, NBC 26.